That's right. And today again, we are going to be bringing to you the word of restoration in the spirit of faith. So God is being glorified this day. Hallelujah. God is being glorified. So, Pastor Pauline.
So I am sharing. I hope you are sharing as you come in. Come on in, come on in. Let your friends and cousins and neighbors know.
Praise God.
Welcome, Sister Barbara.
Hello, Sister Lisa. Good to have you guys on. Hello, Pascal.
Hi, Pastor Karen.
Hello, 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 guys.
Welcome.
We
welcome.
Are ready. Hey, Judy, how are you? God bless you.
Hi, Pastor John.
Amen. Such a lovely call on Pastor Pauline, right?
Oh, thank you.
That's what Sister Lisa is saying.
Thank you, Sister Lisa.
Hello, Pastor John. How are you? Good to see you.
Welcome.
Pastor John, can you imagine Facebook is asking me to bring you on camera? So you never know what can happen.
Hallelujah.
Hey, Kiana, how are you? God bless you. Sister Barbara.
Welcome, Mr. Neddy.
Hallelujah. Okay, Sister Barbara says, you sound so far. Let's see.
Okay, why are you
so I believe far? Sound people will be working on that so we don't sound so far.
Hi, George. Hi, Kiana. Hi, Sister Diana.
Hallelujah.
We are in the house. Welcome.
Praise
welcome.
Praise the Lord.
Hi, Sister Anastasia. Welcome. Welcome.
God bless you.
Hello, Pastor Laurent. Welcome.
Hi. Hey, Pastor Laurent. Pastor Laurent just had his birthday a few days ago.
Oh, happy birthday, man of God.
Happy belated birthday. God bless you, sir.
Welcome, Jermaine Robinson. You're welcome.
Praise the Lord. Well,
welcome,
go ahead,
Jerry,
and we are going to be praying in a little bit.
Pastor John says, what? Hi, Rachel. Vineland in the house. You're welcome.
Hello, Abby.
Welcome, Dominic.
God bless you.
Welcome, Pastor D. Thank you, Pastor Eunice. We both look glorious.
Oh, okay. Nice.
Hallelujah for the glory.
Judy says, Pastor Pauline always looks so beautiful. She wears the Spirit of God so well.
Oh, thank you.
That's nice.
Hallelujah.
Kiana says,
thank you, Holy
Kiana
Ghost.
Says, so how are you? Doing wonderful, Kiana.
Wonderful.
The Lord is good.
Yes,
Sister Barbara says the sound is much better now, so that's good.
Awesome.
Hello.
Oh, that's your uncle, Jalisa. Welcome, Jalisa's uncle.
Okay, nice.
Thank you for logging on.
Hello, Pastor Evelyn. How are you? God bless you. So good to have you on. So good to have you on.
Father,
praise God.
You're looking glorified.
Oh, who said?
Minister Neddy says you're looking glorified. So I said it in her voice.
Right. Okay.
At least I tried.
Okay. Good. Thank you very much. Hallelujah.
Welcome, Pastor Evelyn. You're welcome. Hola, Sister Daisy. Did I say it right? Hola.
Yeah. Hola.
Hola, hola, Sister Daisy.
Hola. Hola. Hallelujah. Listen, guys, for
Hallelujah.
Those of you who have testimonies, you can go ahead and type them out. You know, we'll have the time to read through them. But there have been so many wonderful testimonies.
Yeah. Can we start by talking about some of those testimonies?
Sure. So many things that God has been doing. And it's been lovely. It's been amazing. God is so faithful. So faithful. Pastor Dada was giving us a testimony.
Yes.
And on something that happened where she is. There was there's a resident. She runs a business and an assisted living business. Mm-hmm. And they had taken in the resident who had mobility issues, had mm-hmm. issues walking. And when she went around, the deal with talking about the anointing oil, mm-hmm. she went around and you know, anointed this resident, you know. She recounted that by the next day, the resident could kick her legs up and she was just kicking her legs up. So that's a wonderful
thank
testimony,
you, Lord.
Right?
Yes, you completely know, healed.
God has been doing a lot of great things.
Hallelujah.
A lot of beautiful things. And she also mentioned that And one of her residents woke up saying, all the frogs and all the dogs that have been sleeping with her are all gone.
Gone.
You know, this is, you know, when you look at someone who is in their 80s, you know, and you don't know that they are struggling with, you know, some spiritual entities.
Demonic activity.
You know, that kind of demonic activity. Mm. So it's just great to hear that the woman woke up and screaming, all the frogs and all
and
the dogs. The fact
gone.
That she said all the frogs and all the dogs, you know, that were sleeping with her are all gone. That was just beautiful.
Yes.
That's just good to
yes.
hear. Amen.
Amen.
And people have been having testimonies all over the
yes,
world.
Yes, yes. A lady called me with a testimony about the beautiful relationship that she now has with her husband. And
praise
it wasn't
God.
Like that before, that they were able to talk about the broadcast. Before now, the husband was not so much into speaking in tongues, but throughout the broadcast, he was the one praying in the Holy Ghost. She actually went
Come
to sleep.
On.
The husband completed the broadcast and was telling him, telling her what happened.
Yeah.
And at the end of it, she was like, wow, it looks like we just had our own family corner.
Okay.
I said, yes, that's the plan. That's the
beautiful.
Goal. That's right.
Hello,
have your
Paul.
Own
God
family
bless you.
Corner.
You know, one of the things I want to do today, one of the things I want to do today is acknowledge how much of a blessing Pastor Evelyn has been.
Oh.
Now, Pastor Evelyn, I know you're not thinking about this, but let me make a few comments. This actually came in my being today, and I was, you know, thinking about it. Many of the people who come to the broadcast are people in whose lives or in whose lives we are pouring to a certain level. There's a level or measure of influence we have over these people. Yes, it is true that some other people are coming in that we have not even met, that we just met on Facebook. But Pastor Evelyn, you know, has her own ministry.
Mm-hmm.
You know, she is doing her own thing. And to see that she's been very consistent. Guys, I'm telling you guys, this woman is such a blessing.
Not only
does she come on to watch when it's live, when she misses it, she goes on and creates a watch party. And she watches alongside. You know, sometimes I just sit and I see the comments coming in. It's just so beautiful. It's just so beautiful. So, Pastor Evelyn, I really want to take this opportunity to say God bless you. Richly.
Amen.
God multiply you.
Amen. Amen.
God cause his countenance to shine upon you.
Amen.
Because you have stood with us. And I know you're not just standing for standing's sake. There are people who support you. And their reason for supporting you is just for support's sake. There's nothing they're really getting.
Mm-hmm.
But I understand we are dealing with the kingdom of God. And we can't say that you're not getting anything. But the fact that you've been consistent. The fact that you've been there. And not just that, but the fact that you can watch after the program, meaning there's a connection that you're experiencing, and you've been going on with this. God bless you, woman of God.
We
God
love
you.
We honor you. We appreciate you.
May there be such a marked demarcation. I know demarcations are already marked.
Amen.
But I want you to get the double stress.
Amen.
The emphasis. Let there be a marked demarcation in your life and ministry. May you never fail to have people who would stand with you and push you and move
Amen.
You and who will recognize God in what you're doing.
Amen.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
That's
hallelujah.
Right.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Pastor Evelyn, some of my people are talking. My Mrs. Baby Girl says she loves you so much that you are a blessing.
Amen.
Yeah,
she's saying amen.
She
Pastor Peter,
you,
I love you,
you
both.
You are a gift from God. That's
praise
right.
God. Hallelujah.
Amen, amen.
So
amen.
This is wonderful. This is glorious. Guys, last broadcast was such a blessing.
Oh, yes.
Last broadcast was such a blessing. And today we are going to follow that same vein and touching some other things here and there. And we are believing the Lord to glorify himself again today without exception. Amen.
Amen.
We are believing God for that. So we are going to pray. We are going to pray.
Mm. You,
hallelujah.
Oh, hallelujah.
Father, thanks a million.
Yes, God.
Father, for all you have done. Father, thanks a million. Father, thanks a million. Father, thanks a million. Father, thanks a million. For all you have done. Lord, we thank you for the things that you have done and the things that you're getting ready to do. We yield to you at this time, oh God, and we ask that you would have your way in our lives.
Yes, God.
Thank you, Father, for your faithfulness. Be exalted, Lord God, in Jesus' name. Amen. 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 Whoa, hallelujah.
Amen.
Okay.
It's such a good God.
Hallelujah. Paul says, Family Corner has been a blessing to my life.
Yes.
Giving me a United Nations status.
Woo-hoo!
Hallelujah.
Come on, my God.
Good. Paul recently had a job with the United Nations.
Hallelujah.
And that's such a blessing. He's been without a job for a long
Thank
time.
You, Father.
And that's Thank just you. Glorious. That's just glorious.
Yes.
So we bless the Lord for that.
Hallelujah.
Bless the Lord for that. That's wonderful.
Thank you, Jesus.
Yes.
Isn't God awesome?
He's really Jehovah El Shaddai.
Yes.
Yes.
I remember him saying, all the memorial stones I've been putting, I have paid off.
Yeah.
That's
yeah.
how he said it when he put in his testimony. He said, all the memorial stones. Mm-hmm. He was able to connect the exercise of placing memorial stones to the testimony that yeah. he had. And it's an amazing thing to be able to see God at work,
right.
being able to acknowledge the hand of God in the victories and the successes that we walk into.
Mm.
Hallelujah.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
Praise God.
Thank you, Lord.
So we give God the praise. So Hallelujah. Let's go over to 1 John.
Yes, 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 yes.
1 John. 1 John.
Welcome, Dearies. Good to have you. Good to see you.
Hello, Riscobel. How are you?
First
God bless
John.
You
all should know that scripture by heart, right? First John, what is it?
First John, John. mm-hmm. All right, so First John chapter
First 5. First John chapter 5 verse 4.
It says, for whatsoever is born of God
overcometh
the
world.
And this is
the
victory
that overcometh
the world,
even our faith.
Let's read that again.
For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world, and this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith.
Again.
For whatsoever is born of God overcometh the world, and this is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith.
Pastor Pauline, there are two things
Hallelujah.
That are required for anyone to be able to overcome.
Mm-hmm.
Now, remember, we were talking about being able to ascend onto a mountain so you can move it.
Mm-hmm.
And so there are two things that are absolutely necessary if someone has to walk in overcoming power.
Mm-hmm.
And that is, God bless you, Dereese. Amen. Amen. And those two things are words that Jesus have used in the Word of God. One of them is authority, and the other one is power.
Mm-hmm.
One of them is authority, the other one is power. And we're going to have this conversation so you can see the difference. Because whatever people had to name things or call, these things were in play.
Mm-hmm.
These things were in play. And as we look at, hello, Patrick Chambers, God bless you, how are you? And as we look at these things, we see that they also go with two other words,
mm-hmm.
attention or transformation. And so we are going to have that conversation today and go between these words.
Okay.
Right?
No, man of God.
We are going to go between these words and see what God is saying to us as a people, because we have been called into overcoming power.
Okay.
We have been called also into overcoming authority.
Okay.
And so let's break authority and power down, right? And I want to do that without necessarily coming from Christianese standpoint. In other words, I don't necessarily want to come with the believer's jargon.
Okay.
Okay, the speaking in tongues jargon. Let's just, you know, look at it from day-to-day life.
Okay.
When they say that someone has power, it means they can do and undo.
Okay.
They have power. So, I have given you authority. Okay, so we have power and we have authority.
Okay.
So someone who can do and undo, you know, you say you have power. I have the power to lift this up.
Okay.
Power speaks of capability.
Physical strength, capability.
Yes, capability.
Okay.
Ability. Whether it's physical or not.
Or not. Okay.
But it is what strength you have, mechanism within you with which you can do something.
Okay.
I have the power to punch someone. Mm-hmm. I have the power to do the dishes. Okay. I have the power to build. I have the power to raise something up, to carry it up. Mm-hmm. That is power, capability, strength, ability. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Okay.
So someone who has power has the tools.
Okay. Someone with power has the tools.
Has the tools. Mm-hmm. So because you can have power but not have the ability to exert. To carry out.
Okay.
So all of that is in the realm of power.
Okay.
So power is not just the strength, muscle strength, so mm-hmm. to say, mm-hmm. but it's also the capability, the tools with which you can do that.
Okay.
You can be very powerful, right? But your power cannot pull out a nail. You need a wrench.
Okay.
You know, you need to put it there and then use the power that you have to be able to do that. And so power and power will get the job done. You can use the little power that you have alongside a jack and raise a car.
So power and leverage.
You could say that. But the point is, both of them, the kind of power. Yes, they are all in the power realm.
Okay.
When we are talking power, that's what we are talking about.
Gotcha.
So whether you're talking about power in terms of the leverage that you get from, you know, like a fulcrum, you know, all of that. Mm-hmm. It's still in the realm of power. It's just proper placement for power.
Okay.
So if someone is very muscular, they have been training, mm-hmm. so they have power, right? But if they cannot get to your face to punch you, to bring the effect of that power, then, you know, but then they have power.
They have it.
Yeah. Then they have power. Hello, Sister Esther. God bless you. Good
Looks
to
like
have you on.
Ask people to come in with testimonies, and the testimonies are flooding in.
Okay. So we'll get to that. We'll get to that. In the name of Jesus, we'll get to that. Hallelujah.
Patrick
God is
says
good.
He has a testimony. I see Pastor Evangelist Evelyn typing something also.
Okay. All right, so you guys can go ahead and type out your testimony and we'll pull those out. We'll pull those out and we'll be able to read. We'll read them too. Mm-hmm. So Pastor Pauline, that's power.
Okay.
But power, you can see it is self-generated.
Mm-hmm.
It's you. Power. Okay. Very different from authority. When we are talking about authority, we are talking about what has been given to you. So whether it's been given to you from above or it's been given to you by a collective agreement, it has been given to you and you're operating from what has been given to you. So authority is being delegated.
Okay.
So anyone who has authority is working on borrowed strength.
Okay.
Is working on borrowed
strength.
So it can be taken away from them. Mr. Pony, you see that?
Yes.
It can be taken away from them. And positionally, it almost doesn't apply. Almost doesn't apply. Except in matters of maintaining the relationship with the one who has handed down that authority to you. So I'll give an example. Democratically speaking. Someone is put in a position of authority.
Mm-hmm.
They may not have the power to slap you, punch you, and you fall.
Right.
Right?
Right.
But they have the backing of the collective agreement.
Right. So that's authority now.
That's authority.
Gotcha.
So authority is this. It is not elusive.
Mm-hmm.
It is not elusive. It is this right to execute. Mm-hmm. And when someone in authority.
Ooh, I like that. Right to execute.
Yes, right to execute. Right to execute. When someone in authority releases a statement, mm-hmm. they are not the ones who's doing it,
right?
Who's going to carry it out? Mm-hmm. So they don't need to go and carry it out. They don't need to have power.
Power.
As long as they are in agreement with their constituent, what happens is there are people who would make sure that that thing comes to pass. This is important for us to understand.
It brings to mind a scripture. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's important for us to understand
Hallelujah.
This.
Hallelujah.
Because Jesus is speaking, right?
To execute.
Jesus is speaking. He says, up till now, you have not asked me anything. Mm-hmm. But ask my Father in my name. Mm-hmm. You see that?
Yes.
Okay, so Jesus is showing you that you don't have the authority to just ask for things and get them. Mm-hmm. That you have to use his authority, and then the Father will give it to you.
So you come in his name.
You go in his name.
Okay.
That's interesting, right?
Yes.
This is interesting. Hello. Wow. I think it is Pastor Deborah Kabila. Is it Apostle Deborah Kabila? Good to have you on, woman of God. So that's the difference between power and mm-hmm. authority, mm-hmm. right? Mm-hmm. So if you are going after power and authority and you don't realize that to remain in authority, you have to be inclined to transformation, you will have problems.
Say that again. Say it again.
When you're
more slowly this time.
More slowly. Okay. So I'm going to try that. So you guys remember what I said about power,
yes.
right? Power is more of what you can do.
Ability.
Capability, right? That's you. Mm-hmm. But then you also need authority. I said there are two things that are required for someone to walk in overcoming power. Mm-hmm. They have to have power as raw power, and then they have to have authority. Mm-hmm. Many people have power. You see, the realm of gifts and talents, skill, mm-hmm. that's power.
Right.
Right? That's mm-hmm. power. Some people like power. You know, they like power. I pray for them and then they fail. Okay, so, and then they were slain. So that's power. People like raw power.
Power.
There are people who fast for the anointing. Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. That's power. That's you seeking after power. But now, if you can understand the difference between power and authority and realize that with authority comes transformation, then you realize that authority, and also realize that authority is promoted by transformation, then you see the value of relationship.
Ooh.
So then,
that's a mouthful right there.
Yeah. So if I dwell in a good relationship,
right?
And when we are talking about relationship, Pastor Pauline, we are speaking beyond the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus.
Yes.
We are speaking beyond the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus. We are talking about the build up on the righteousness of God in Christ
yes.
Jesus.
Daily, vibrant, active
yeah.
interaction.
Right. That's what we are talking about. Mm-hmm. So as long as this relationship is nurtured by constant understanding and therefore transformation, because the word of God says to understand means to turn away. Mm-hmm. So when we understand, okay, the master doesn't want me in this place, and we are therefore transformed by what we now know, the master bestows upon us greater levels of authority. So you can be in a meeting. Oh, this is where I like this. You can be in a meeting, right, Pastor Pauline?
Yes, sir.
And there are 50 lame people. Mm-hmm. The person with power wants to lay hands on each of them. And that's okay. Mm-hmm. But the person with authority,
operating on the anointing that is on their life.
Right. They are operating under the anointing on their life. And that's okay. Mm-hmm. But there is this other level where someone just puts their hand and say, come out of the wheelchair now in the name of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Come out of the wheelchair in the name of Jesus. Come out of the wheelchair in the name of Jesus. This person has heard from their authority.
So what I do is what I see my father do.
Yes. They have heard from their authority. God has given them what to say. Mm-hmm. Then they say it and then he goes to show that he said it.
Mm-hmm. Shall be done.
Yes. It shall be done. So we can see We can see this. Okay, so hold on. So let's read this right here. Let's read this.
You're welcome to Family Corner if you're just joining us.
Yes!
This is a Kange household of faith.
Where we
bring to you the word of restoration in
the
spirit
of
faith.
Yes.
We are talking about power and authority. And Pastor Peter asked a question earlier on, are you going for attention or are you going for transformation?
Yeah, this is very important. Now, in John chapter 15, verse 16, listen to how Jesus puts it. He says, ye have not chosen me, but I have chosen you and ordained you that you should go and bring forth fruit, and that your fruit should remain, that whatsoever ye shall ask the Father in my name, he may give it you. So you can see where authority comes into play. So Pastor Pauline, there's a difference between I want a car and I go to the store and get a car. I have the power to get it.
Yeah.
My credit, my all of that, I have the power to get it. Mm-hmm. Then there is this other level where God says, this, my child, is moving in the work that I have called them to do, so I will release a car for them. So when we are talking about authority, you're working with the collaboration of the unit.
Oh, I like that. Working with the collaboration of the unit.
Yes, working with the collaboration of the unit.
So you come heavily defended.
You come heavily defended. The centurion said, I am a man under authority. So I can say, and
come
it
on.
Is as I have said.
Yes,
it.
Yes.
So authority is when you are able to move in power that you don't have, but that those who placed you have.
So, I mean, a common example will be the policeman, right?
Yes.
Just because he's wearing that uniform, he lifts up his hand and the cars stop.
Yes.
But, I mean, physically speaking, he may not even have the power to withstand any of the drivers of that of those cars.
That's level one. Level two, he cannot stand any of the vehicles.
Right.
If someone says, I'm going to run over you, they will more than likely run over you.
Him. Yes.
But you see, Pastor Pauline, this is the thing. Why do we need both? And why should we absolutely go for authority? Because the thing we have to deal with is not necessarily subject to power.
Mm.
Okay, so this is important.
Yes.
This is important.
Very important.
When sickness comes into your life, and someone can look at you and see sickness, and can see curses, and can see, you know, what the devil is doing in your life, it's because you have been overpowered
by another power.
This power does not take from you. Its intention is to enslave you.
Right.
So you want to go for authority, because then a higher power,
come on, a higher power
can come into the circumstance and override.
Yes.
Your situation. Ooh. So I can be healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I can be delivered in the name of Jesus. I can speak to demons and they leave.
Yes. Yes.
The sons of Sceva were talking about Paul.
Right.
Jesus. Right? Mm-hmm. Okay. Jesus whom Paul preaches. Okay, we get that. Mm-hmm. We get that. Mm-hmm. But you are tapping into beyond power. You had the power to bring the demoniac.
Right.
But you did not have the authority to cast the demon. I hope you're hearing us this day, child of God. We must go for authority.
For authority.
So if you have to be in and dwell in overcoming power, you have to have authority.
Yes.
Those two things have to come into play.
Amen.
So now we are going to bring in some other scriptures so you see how this plays with transformation, right? I mean, we have to talk about this.
Yeah, because with authority, and you're dealing with transformation, because for you to operate in a certain level of authority, you have to come into a place of compliance.
Right, because a person in authority who is also rebellious to the one or the ones who put him in authority is someone who is getting ready to be kicked out.
Yes.
You're getting ready to be kicked out. That's very different from, I have the power, I can do what I want to do. You know, like people say, it's my life, I can do. Okay, well, congratulations, you have a life that you can do and undo. But when the devil will come and exert his authority over you, that will be the day you will look for higher authority.
You will look for higher authority.
You look for higher authority.
Right.
But may God help us understand this so we can come into a place of freedom.
Yes. Amen.
Because we have been called unto freedom.
Yes.
We've been called unto freedom. Yeah.
But being in authority means you are under authority.
Yes. That is what that really means.
And the challenge that we have as children of God is that sometimes we have this attitude of, it's my life. And when you do, it's my life, then you are functioning at a level of power.
Come on.
Without authority, because when you come into a place where you are under authority, then you have to deal with compliance to the one that is the authority.
Yes.
So that brings in the word transformation.
That's right.
Because you have to align.
You,
when you talk about compliance, you're talking about transformation.
Yeah.
Because that's what brings you into a place of alignment. So most of the time, we don't want to pay the price of alignment. So we have a lot of people operating with power, but no authority.
Yes.
We don't want to settle for power, guys.
No, we don't.
We want to go for authority.
We don't.
Because within authority, you have both authority and power.
You know, I was listening to this story of this man of God who was dealing with a demonic case. This demonic case, they had to pray against curses and they had to do like a family deliverance kind of thing. And the demonic spirits began to speak. And they were accusing the man of God of several things. They accused him of the fact that he is like them. and as the accusations went on, the man of God listened. When the demonic spirits were done talking, the man of God said, I subscribe to Jesus.
Oh, come on.
He said, I subscribe to Jesus right now. In the name of Jesus, leave.
That's right.
So you see, this is interesting, right? Because the man of God could say, all powers that be. So I am running to Jesus. Because as a power, because here you are accusing me. You are accusing me that I did things. So you're saying that I had the power to do them. So I should be accountable. Right? Which is another thing we are going to be looking at, because people in authority have to be accountable. And so many people run away from transformation because they don't want to be accountable.
That's a can of worms you just opened, Pastor Paul.
They're running away from authority because they don't want to be accountable. Because Pastor Pauline, think about it. What happens in churches? Much of the conversation that is going around in churches today, that has to do with, well, I don't want a pastor. Oh, well, I don't want a pastor. Well, why should I tithe? Or why should I do this? Those are conversations of rebellion.
Yeah, because you don't want to be accountable.
You don't want to be accountable. Because the truth about it is, tithe is not just about you bring 10%. It is also you being able to be accountable to whatever the whole is, so you can bring the 10.
Oh, yeah. Especially the first 10.
Yeah, that should be the first 10, right?
Yeah.
And many people don't want to do that.
Yeah.
They don't want to do that. They don't want to come into accountability.
Accountability.
But we must subscribe to transformation so someone can say, well, I see how much you've been transformed. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going. Keep going.
I mean, Jesus said it in Luke chapter 16. He said, he gave a parable about the kingdom of God. He said, the kingdom of God is likened as unto.
Yeah.
And the parable was about a man that had to travel, and he had his servants, and he gave them instructions. And he said, when he came back, he heard word, and he said, what is this thing that I'm hearing about you? I need for you to give me account, without which you will no longer be a steward.
Yes.
So if I'm in position of authority and you are under that authority, you are supposed to be accountable, right? So if I'm under the authority of the kingdom of God, I have a responsibility to be accountable to God. And he says, if you don't give me proper accounts of what you've been doing with your life, you may no longer be a steward.
Yeah.
Which means you can be dethroned from your position of power.
Right.
If you are not submitted and aligned to the authority.
You know, Pastor Pauline,
Oh, wow.
In that particular story, this young man went out and began to talk to those who owed his master.
Yeah.
That was power and authority at work.
Yes.
He could go. Mm-hmm. He had the power to go.
He had the power to go.
He could talk. Mm-hmm. He had the power to talk. Mm-hmm. He could negotiate. Mm-hmm. He had the power to negotiate. But if his master had removed him prior to that from being his steward, he would not have been able to do it.
He would not have been able to do it because he would no longer be in position of authority.
That's it. That's it.
Because then he was going in the name of his master.
Right. So it is important for us to see where all of this comes in. Yes, we overcome the world, but how do these two ingredients work together? Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. How do they work together? Pastor Pauline, that's the reason why you find people who say, for example, you ask them how they're doing. Hey, sister so-and-so, how are you doing? I am strong. It is their way of telling you that they are not doing
they
well.
They are not doing well.
Okay. But this is the problem. This is the problem, Pastor Pauline. This is the thing right here.
Yes.
You can already sense it. Mm-hmm. This is the thing. When you say, I am strong, and it's your way of saying you are not doing well, mm-hmm. you have taken or assumed the authority with which healing comes, but you have denied the power thereof. Mm-hmm. And so now it's like a Ponzi scheme. You are pushing pieces, but you're not serious about the pieces you're pushing. Oh my God.
So it ends at the level of the words. You've adopted the language without the...
But
the,
you don't have the transformation.
The transformation that goes with it.
Because when you say, when someone says, hey brother, how are you? And then you say, I am strong. It should be, I am strong.
Yes, it should be a faith declaration. And you mean it.
And I'm not...
And not I am strong as to say, I want you to know I'm very weak, but as a way I'm saying it.
Yes,
so you
and
can
then
get
and
it.
Then please could you interpret that?
Right.
So not only are you speaking in a way that you shouldn't speak, but you're inviting others to solidify this weak state of yours. Mm-hmm. Oh,
hence the question you asked. Are you going for attention or are you going for transformation?
First of all, I'll just give that right there. I mean, I've seen it play out several times. I've seen how someone goes for the feeling they have, the how much they can be taken care of.
Ooh.
Pastor Pauline, this is what we are saying. We are saying we reject the solace that comes with being taken care of. Mm-hmm. When we are not doing so well.
Right.
We reject that solace.
In the name of Jesus.
We reject mm-hmm. all Elkanahs mm-hmm. mm-hmm. who want to pacify us with yes. double offerings.
Yes.
In case you're wondering, what is Pastor Ooh. Peter is saying? Who is Elkanah?
Elkanah. Stay there for a little bit.
I should stay there. I will stay yes. there. Yes. Elkanah was married to Hannah mm-hmm. and married to Peninnah.
Yes.
Peninnah had children. Hannah hadn't any mm-hmm. at the time.
Right.
And Peninnah was in the habit of provoking
right.
Hannah. Elkanah never stood up and said, Peninnah, you don't need to do this.
Right.
No, he never took that approach.
Instead, he said, I'm worth more than 10 sons to you. Talking
he
to Hannah.
He was carrying out a pacifying system.
Yeah.
So, Hannah, you just stay the way you are. You don't need any children. I am more to you than seven sons.
And I'll give you a double offering.
I am not just your husband. I'm also the children that you want. And Hannah is thinking, you sleep with me. I don't want you as a child. Okay, so I'm just saying.
Right.
Right. So
I want my own children.
Right. So, Hannah just said, So, when she went into the time of prayer, she prayed that through.
Yes.
And had her miracle. Mm-hmm. Elkanah didn't say, no, we don't want it because I'm enough children to you. Mm-mm. You see, these things that people come into, it seems right on one side, but very demonic on the other side. Yeah. Okay, so let's come back on this side. He was doing his best to pacify Hannah with those statements. offerings. Mm-hmm. Pacify her with double offerings. Mm-hmm. Because he would give her more than he gave all the others. Mm-hmm. But the devil is a liar. The devil is a liar. We don't only want power. We also want authority. We don't want to be pacified into remaining the same.
Right. And you see that sometimes even you can bring this home with your own relationships around you. Are there times when you rather have someone, you know, pacify you and pamper you in a situation, or would you rather have them tell you the truth so you can get into a place of change and result? Mm.
Yeah.
Because I can give an example. I had a situation the other day. I bumped my toe very badly and the nail practically came off. And I was like, this is not happening, because I had just listened to a message by Pastor Chris Oyakhilome, and he was talking about how he practiced faith on himself. Mm-hmm. And he will have a wound and he will speak over it and say, healed in Jesus' name.
Amen.
And gradually he got to the point where he spoke like that and was healed instantly. So in that moment, when that thing happened with me and my toe, I remembered that message. And I'm like, I put it back where it's supposed to be. And I said, healed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
I said, I'm going to practice this too for myself.
That's right.
So I spoke about it like that and I left it at that. And I knew how I felt like, ooh, I need to tell Pastor Peter about this toe thing. And then I remembered like, no, I don't want a situation where he might say, oh, I'm sorry, let me look at it.
But you know I would not say that.
I know you're not even so, that kind of so person. You, because you would just be like, healed in the name of Jesus. You know,
right.
But there are times when you say things to people because you want a little bit of their attention and their affection. Like, oh, sorry, baby. Let's see. You know, like you do with the three-year-old. I bumped my hand. When did you bump? You know, like when the grandkids come around. I bumped my toe. They show you the toe. When did you? It was since last week.
Right.
But now that they see you, they act like it just happened.
Yeah.
Because they want you to do, sorry. And as adults, we do that sometimes. So you want the extra attention instead of going for the power of
Come
God
on.
To see transformation and healing.
Yeah.
So I'm not telling Pastor Peter about this. As much as I know you're not that kind of person, I'll be like, but I'm like, because I know that side of me that wanted to tell you
yeah.
was looking for a little bit of that sympathy and, wow, this happened to you.
You know, everything we do it from practicing.
Right.
So here you are talking about practicing faith on yourself.
Yes.
And it has to be the case.
Yes.
I remember years ago, Pastor, you remember that thing? Years ago, when Bishop Oyedepo was talking about having, you know, left his wife at the hospital.
Mm-hmm.
In fact, he totally forgot that she was giving birth.
Mm.
And we had a conversation about it.
Mm-hmm.
But you can see where someone would say, I cannot believe my husband did not make it.
Right.
I know, ladies, I'm talking to many of you right
no,
now.
No, he has to be there when I'm giving birth. Is he the doctor? Is he the midwife? If he's there, great. If he's not there, it should be okay.
Right.
Right.
So there are some of these things that we push and not realize that we are practicing flesh over faith.
Yeah.
And that's what we are talking
yeah,
about
Yeah, because
here.
If God is sending you to somewhere, I won't insist that you should come and sit there.
Yeah.
As if, what are you doing? Sitting in the waiting room waiting for me?
Wow.
You should be going about the Father's business, knowing that the Father is taking care of your business.
Right.
You know, that place of faith mm-hmm. is what we are talking about. Not being pacified into, sorry, you're being pampered and you enjoy the fact that they're bringing you breakfast in bed. So you want to let the sickness linger 3 more days so you can command everybody around you. They treat you like
queen. You know, there are some people who will actually say, well, I carried the baby for 9 months. The least you can do is be here.
Right. Oh my goodness, that's another thing. That's another level of entitlement.
I carried the baby, so you come on. You should be the one to massage my feet. So listen, guys. I've heard so many teachings around marriage. You know, keeping the flame in the home and doing those kind of things. And sometimes I sit and I listen to these things and I'd say, Father, help me build within me such a resilience against the flesh. And that's how I began to see in the Word of God that the Bible says he took away our sorrows.
Mm-hmm.
And I began to practice not to say, I am sorry.
Right. But rather because say, I apologize.
I apologize. Because I don't want to be sorrow. I don't want to be the embodiment of sorrow.
Yeah.
The Bible says he took away our sorrows. So I want to be able to say, I want to be able to say, if someone says, oh, you just stepped on my toe, I want to make sure that I say, oh, I apologize. I didn't realize that, or one of those kind of things, and not say, and now I have become sorrow. Mm-hmm. I am sorry. Like someone would say, I am hungry. I am poor. You become the embodiment of these things.
I am shy.
I am shy. So someone looks at you and they see what being shy looks like. Mm-hmm. So you may not say the word, but someone looks at you and sees
and
it.
They see it.
The devil is a liar. I don't want you to look at me and you see sorrow. Mm-hmm.
Don't look at me and see hunger. The devil is a liar.
Right? Okay, so someone can say, so what does that mean? So how do we mourn? You can mourn, but not in sorrow. The Bible says we don't mourn
like the unbelievers who don't have hope. Yes.
So our hope brings our mourning to a whole new level.
Right.
Where we rejoice and praise God for what is coming. That will meet them again. That whoever this person isn't dead, but they are sleeping.
Pastor Peter, I think this topic on whether we want transformation or attention is huge, because some of the things that we have engaged in doing in the body of Christ and some of the things that we have moved into teaching, we moved into those teachings as some kind of damage control.
Yeah.
Because if you look at the word of God, they were not actually part of God's word like that. Mm-hmm. If we are supposed to walk by faith and not by sight,
yes.
If we are living in the spirit and not in the flesh, scripture says live in the spirit, mm-hmm. and you will not fulfill the desires of the flesh.
Yeah.
If you walk in the spirit, if we are indeed walking in the spirit, there are some things that we now take time to teach people, and
yeah.
it's damage control.
Yeah.
Like we have now gone into psychology and counseling more than we've gone into deliverance and the power of God.
Yeah.
Where we are now canceling demonic cases instead of casting out the demons.
Right.
Because there is no authority. So we are walking in the realm of power. So let's see how we can manage the situation. So we come up with all of these different techniques as well as a result of some of these things. Because if we really go for transformation, then we will be on that same page where we agree it is about the word of God.
Yeah.
Let's go for the word.
Yeah.
Let's go for the word. So yeah. If the word of God says, by the stripes of Jesus, I'm healed.
Then by
the stripes of
Jesus,
I'm healed. Even if I want to say, okay, if you say, how are you? I said, okay, I woke up this morning with this pain like this, but I prayed, so I know it's gone in the name of Jesus.
That's right.
That's a testimony I'm Amen. Giving you. I'm not saying, oh, there's this pain. Can you just massage it a little bit? And then let me just stay here. Can you bring me soup from the kitchen? And then now you're creating something else entirely. You are feeding off of that attention. You want the attention.
So Pastor Pauline, we are saying you can have a massage all you want.
You can ask for a massage if you want to without attaching it to something that is demonic.
Right.
Why you have to have sickness attached to it to get a massage? If you have to fake sickness to get a massage out of your husband, then we need to reevaluate that relationship.
That's right.
Just ask for the massage.
Now
it's
parasitic.
Yeah.
Now it's parasitic, and parasitic relationships are very unhealthy.
They are very unhealthy. So don't entertain that.
So we are talking about these things, and you can see how much they are an enemy to faith.
Yeah, they are.
They are an enemy to faith. They are an enemy to our victorious living.
Yes,
in Christ Jesus.
Yes, because it makes you entertain things that have no business being for the attention.
Yeah.
For the attention, it takes me to a scripture in Mark chapter 10. It talks about blind Bartimaeus, right?
Yeah.
Mark chapter 10. The Bible says he cried out to Jesus and he said, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And it kind of looked like he was looking for attention because everybody was trying to shush him.
Right.
Mark chapter 10, I'm going to read from verse 46. And they came to Jericho, and as he went out of Jericho with his disciples and a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. Mm-hmm. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and said, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And many charged him that he should hold his peace. But he cried the more, a great deal, thou son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood still. Now he got Jesus' attention. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And commanded him to be called. And they called the blind man, saying unto him, be of good comfort, rise, he calleth thee. Take note of verse 50. And he, casting away his garment, rose and came to Jesus.
That's transformation.
That's transformation. He wasn't looking for attention.
Anyone who wants transformation anticipates the transformation and acts the transformation. You can see it in their behavior. So you have to cast off the garment.
Yes.
So you cannot long for romantic soup when you have a fever. And at the same time, expect that the prayer of faith
will get you
will work.
You want it to work, but you want to enjoy the perks that come.
You can
in
have
the guise of the
so you can have soup.
Yeah.
All you want.
Yes.
And cast the sickness.
Yes.
Maintaining the word of God right where it belongs. Mm-hmm. You are growing in faith the way you're supposed to.
Yes.
You know, seriously.
And then go have the romantic soup if you want to.
Right. Right.
It doesn't have to be connected to sickness.
It doesn't have to be. So these are loopholes that the enemy comes in and makes children of God practice unbelief.
Pastor Peter, we've had cases where someone calls.
Yeah.
And they say, oh, I have a situation and I need prayer for. And you're giving them the word of God so you can pray. And they start telling you a story. Oh, the thing is, and then they're excusing every scripture you give them. They are not looking for transformation.
No, they are not.
They are looking for attention.
Yeah.
They just want to add your name to the list of names of preachers that they have ministered to them and nothing happened.
Right. Pastor Pauline, look at Jesus dealing with, here we are talking about blind Bartimaeus. Mm-hmm. The other blind man, he said, go wash.
Right.
There must be a proclivity to move toward your freedom.
Yes.
Then we know you are not seeking for attention.
Attention. You want transformation. The moment Jesus called for him, he cast off the old garment that represented his blind state.
Right.
He cast it off because he knew as he's going to Jesus, he's not leaving the presence of Jesus blind.
Oh my God.
But this is another case of somebody else in the same Mark chapter 10 who was seeking for attention.
Okay, so let's look at that.
He was definitely seeking for attention. Let me see. Mark chapter 10 is talking about a rich young ruler.
So that's verse 17.
That's verse 17.
Yes, ma'am.
Is that where I want to start? And when he was gone forth into the way, there came one running and kneeled to him and asked him, good master, what shall I do that I may inherit eternal life?
First of all, you know, this is, you know, whenever I read this, it makes me laugh. It just makes you look at Christians that you have who say, pastor, please pray for me, pray for me.
Yes.
And you are thinking, you really don't want the prayer.
No, you don't.
I'm not sure why you're here.
Oh, pastor, I've been struggling with this situation. What should I do?
You really don't
want
the
answer. But
they don't
want the answer.
They want 5 minutes of conversation.
Yeah, they just want that time with you so they can ramble.
Okay, so let's read that.
What should I do to inherit eternal life? And Jesus said unto him, why callest thou me good? There is none good but one, that is God. Thou knowest the commandments. Do not commit adultery. Do not kill. Do not steal. Do not bear false witness. Defraud not. Honor thy father and mother. And he answered and said unto him, master, all this have I observed from my youth. You see that thing I was saying about, oh, I've been there, done that. You are telling the person, you know, this is what you need in order to walk in your healing. Mm-hmm. Oh, I've done that. I know the scripture. Before you even complete it, oh, I know. Oh, I know.
Because this is what happened. Jesus was still mentioning the commandments. He had not finished.
Yeah. And he said, I've done all of that from my youth.
Yeah.
Like, done that, bought a t-shirt.
You know?
Like, I've done that. And sometimes your ministry, and they tell you, oh, you know, I went to that other church, and they prayed for me, and nothing happened. And then I went to the other man of God, and he prayed, and nothing happened. And then I went to this, and then they're telling all these stories. Hold on. You requested for prayer. I am trying to tell you how the word of God, what the word of God says, so we can pray. I'm not interested in the stories about how many other people have prayed and it didn't work.
Come on.
Not interested about the different things that were done to you at the other church.
Mm.
And most of the time, these are the people who always talk about church hurt.
Right.
And then this person did this to me. And another one did that. And another one did that. Oh, hold on. The reason why you called is that you needed prayer.
Right.
How did we move into all these conversations with so many people's names inside?
Right.
I've been there, done that.
And Jesus went there when he said, and he answered and said unto him, master, all these have I observed
from my youth.
So this is what we are saying. If you have observed from your youth, then you should have experienced transformation.
Exactly.
It is only the person who has observed from their youth, who hasn't come into alignment with authority, who has not had the effect of the word in their life.
Yes.
And that's called religion.
Yes. So you've been in rituals.
So a form of godliness, but yeah, denying the power thereof.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So you have things like, well, I've done that, but it's not working. Mm. Just give me 3 steps. You are still looking for techniques and mechanics.
Oh my
you
God.
Just want mechanics. So you're looking for formula instead of relationship. You want techniques, but you don't want to go for the commitment.
Yeah.
Because when you're talking about authority, you're talking about commitment.
Yes.
When you talk about accountability, you're talking about commitment.
Yes.
Oh, so we want a quick fix.
Yeah.
How can I just get it and go?
Yes.
I don't want to be involved in all of those other things. Just tell me the 2 steps so I can get it and go.
But the substance of faith rests in the connection of the one who has spoken to you.
That's it. He says, I am the vine and you are the branches.
That's it. So as long as there is a rupture in that relationship, we are having
you dry out.
You dry out.
If you don't stay connected to the vine,
yeah,
as a branch, you will dry out. That's why sometimes people think, oh, I'm fine. Nothing is wrong with me because you're still looking green. But do you know that when a tree is cut down, it still looks green for a few days? You can still be looking green and fresh and you think you're doing fine. But you've been cut off already. Mm. And we'll start seeing the dryness as time goes on. So God wants you to stay connected to the vine. So when we're talking authority, it has to do with commitment. It has to do with relationship.
Yes.
So we're not talking rituals. We're not talking techniques. We're not talking formulas. Mm-mm. Give me 2 steps. Let me just get this thing and go. Mm-mm. I'm not interested in the rest of these things. Like I want to come to church and get my healing and go. I don't want to be involved in all these church things.
So
you know, Pastor Pauline, stuff like that.
Pastor Pauline, so as we look at the word of God tonight, you know, teaching the word of God, bringing clarity, bringing illumination mm-hmm. to the people who are listening to us. We want people to understand why 1 John chapter 5, verse 4 is what it is.
Yes.
This is the victory that overcometh the world, even our faith. So we are overcomers.
Yes.
And in overcoming, we need these 2 things.
Yes.
That absolutely have to be present.
Yes.
Power and authority. These are things that God mentions in his word.
Yes.
There must be power. Mm-hmm. Behold, I give unto you power mm-hmm. to tread upon scorpions and serpents. Mm-hmm. He gave them authority. He gave them power over unclean spirits.
That's right.
So we see these things in the word of God. That both are essential.
Yes.
Jesus said, all authority is given to me. All power has been given to me. So now I'm sending you. So if you're not going as one who is sent, then you cannot tap into the rights that
yes,
I have.
That's right.
So that's what God is saying to us. So we are also seeing that one who is coming into not just power, but authority has to come into transformation.
Yes.
Has to come into alignment.
Yes.
Because without the honor of the one who has delegated authority unto you, and we were talking and we're saying authority is either delegated by the one or is delegated by the many.
Yes.
And so when we are talking about a president, the authority for him to be president came from the masses. Mm-hmm. He was put in that, in that position
right.
to be president. One can have delegated authority. So if the one who has been positioned to have authority begins to do things that are not in alignment with those who made them authority, what happens is...
They'll be brought into questioning.
They'll
have to give account.
And they may take it out. Right. So accountability is one of those things.
That's right.
So now we have come to the point where we are now saying, okay, child of God, listen. Do you want to walk in sustained power?
Oh, come on.
If you want to walk in sustained power.
Yes.
And not limit your life and ministry to just giftings. talents mm-hmm. and skills. Mm-hmm. Because in the body of Christ today, we have come, and listen, guys, I'm not saying body of Christ in a derogatory manner. I'm saying body of Christ as in the institution.
Yes.
Okay? With the utmost respect. The body of Christ is the body of Christ.
Yes.
The body of Christ has flaws within it. Mm-hmm. And that doesn't make it something other than the body of Christ.
No.
It is exactly what it is.
That's why he gave us his word. It is with the word Good. That he's washing us.
Good.
So we can come into that place.
In the body of Christ today, many are still being transformed. Many are still being transformed from their reliance on power. Mm-hmm. To seeing the authenticity of the relationship
right.
that we have with Christ Jesus.
Yes.
So the Bible says we are being reconciled
yes.
to Christ.
Yes.
There is a reconciliation. There is a reconciliation that's happening on a constant basis. On a constant basis. So as long as I am where Christ wants me to be in my relationship with him, mm-hmm. then I am being reconciled also.
Yes.
He says, this sign shall follow them that believe. This sign shall follow them that believe. Believe in what? Believe in what I'm saying. Mm-hmm. Because as I'm relating with you, I am transfusing within you. Right? Mm-hmm. There is a transfusion happening of what I have to what you have. And I'm extrapolating, as it were, what shouldn't be within you.
Right.
So there is this constant take out
yes.
and put in.
Yes.
Take out, put in. Take out, put in. It's like someone who is going through dialysis. Mm-hmm. God is constantly purifying our
yes,
status.
Yes.
Constantly yes, purifying us.
Yes.
Constantly purifying us.
And that
us
only happens by reason of the relationship.
Right. He's purifying us from the sweeties.
Ooh.
You know, the pleasures mm-hmm. of the flesh.
Yeah. Pleasures of the flesh, but they are dangerous. They are toxic to your blood.
Yeah. So toxic someone could have a skill, but the skill is not reconciled mm-hmm. with Christ. Mm-hmm. They can boast about their skill, so they're in a realm of power.
Yes.
You can be a musician and you can play so skillfully, mm-hmm. but David beats you
yeah.
because his own skillful playing will cast a demon.
Oh, yes.
Because that's what authority is.
That's what authority is.
That's what authority is.
And that's what a transformation is.
That's it. Someone who is sick is someone who has been overpowered
yes
by sickness,
the spirit of infirmity,
by the spirit of infirmity, and therefore requires authority, a higher authority
yes.
in this case
yes.
to be taken away from sickness, to be taken away from pain, to be taken away from curses, to be taken away from poverty. And that's what we are talking about.
So in that case, they are not looking for your eloquence. They are not looking for your skill. They are not looking for your intelligence, your academia. They are looking for someone who can operate with the authority that is higher than the power that has overpowered them.
Yeah, and that's what Jesus said. Paul.
Yep.
Paul said, I did not come talking to you about all of this big words. Mm.
Cunningly devised fables.
Yeah, that's
I did not,
not
come
why
to you with enticing words of man's wisdom.
I just came to talk to you about God
yeah.
and his power to deliver.
Yeah.
It's all in Jesus.
I determined not to know anything among you save Jesus and him crucified.
Pastor Pauline, the other day, I saw this miracle.
My father.
This boy had a broken bone. And the bone was protruding from the flesh. Down his leg. And he was carried to a service. And he had been like that for a while. Mm-hmm. Couldn't go to school. Couldn't walk, you know. And the power of God came on that boy. And a few weeks later on, another bone had grown and pushed the broken one Oof. Out. And the flesh thereof had been covered. Give me Jesus or give me Jesus.
Yes.
I'm telling you, give yes. me Jesus or give me Jesus. Listen, guys. I remember very well when I gave my life to Jesus. It was about, if I see something in the word of God, it has to be true.
Yes.
I don't want, please guys, listen to me. Listen, people. Listen. I have done psychology. I don't want to do it again. No, I'm not. I have done, let us counsel the people, let them understand, let them, I don't want to do it again. I have refused. I don't want to do it again. I don't want to tickle people's intelligence. Oh, right. He speaks smart. I don't care. Who cares about that? That is not taking anyone to heaven. Mm-mm. I want raw Jesus.
Yes.
Where they say the eye grew up in the socket. And then you look at it and you say, oh God.
Yes.
People will not stand and praise God for your eloquence.
No.
Anyone can be eloquent. The unbeliever is eloquent.
Yes.
Moses was eloquent while in Egypt.
Yes.
And when the power of God came upon him to do the work he's supposed to do, he refused the eloquence. Pastor Pauline, we need authority.
Yes.
Authority that goes to God and say, I need eyes in this socket. I need a new womb in this in this body because the womb was taken away. I need this. I need that. That authority with God and with man.
Yes. That is the cry of our hearts.
Oh my God.
That is where we are leaning in into the word of God more and more to see. We are pressing into the glory of God more and more every day because we want to see greater levels of that authority in operation in our lives. And the more the yielding, the more the manifestation of that level of authority. So I am not satisfied with where I am. I am pressing in for more because God has also put in the body of Christ, we can see people that are ahead of us who have paid the price to operate at the level of authority in which they are operating.
Yes.
So we can look at them and see possibilities.
Yes. Yes. Pastor Pauline, I don't mind being a praise dancer.
But I don't want to entertain anybody.
And I can go to school to learn greater skills. But I don't want you to tell me after that that I danced very well.
Oh, you danced very well. Oh, Lord, that's an insult.
To the glory of God.
Yes.
That's an insult to the glory of God.
It is.
I want to finish dancing. And people are all over the floor worshiping God.
Yes.
And they are not saying, where is she?
No.
They are saying, oh, God, where are you?
Yes. They are crying out to God in repentance. They are crying out to
God
in complete awe and worship of Him.
My God, my God,
they are being slain in the spirit. Their focus is Jehovah.
Yeah.
That's it.
That's what we
that's
are looking
the agenda.
For. Talking about power and authority.
Oh,
and authority is the greater side of it. Pastor Pauline, when I was explaining the whole concept behind power, right? Do you notice that in the book of Hebrews, the Bible mentions things that are at the level of power as elementary?
Yes.
Laying on of hands is elementary. So we need to move from these things that we are doing to this place where we say, Father, what is it that you want me to say?
Yes.
And then he says, tell them that I'm the healer, I am here.
Yes.
Then you say, God said he's the healer,
and
he's here. And then God moves into the crowd and begins to do things. And then when people sit down and they say, Pastor Colleen, you know, I've always been amazed. I do love Robert Lyonon. He did such a great, he's such a great Bible historian.
Yes.
I should say revival historian.
Yes.
He's doing such an amazing job. Do you see how, permit me use the term, almost scanty of words, someone like Smith Wigglesworth's preaching is?
Right.
You can almost chuckle and say, because you're kind of looking for the preaching that had all of those miracles. And you don't kind of see it. You listen to some people who were not so refined. Their English wasn't so refined. Mm-hmm. In fact, some of them spoke as it were patois. It was broken, broken English. And then you listen to their miracles and you're thinking, that was it. He did not even quote so many scriptures. Yeah. The guy just sat on one scripture and said, oh God, thank you. This is where I die and this is where I live. This verse you have given to me today. And people experience miracles.
Because they had to move to a certain level of dying to flesh.
My God.
Dying to self, dying to their personality and their reputation to be able to see the power of God in that magnitude. We are not saying that it's wrong for you to be eloquent. We are not saying that God is not interested in excellence, because the Bible talks about Daniel and how he had an excellent spirit with him. We are saying let the excellence match the glory.
Yes.
If you have to choose one, go for the glory.
Yeah. In fact, we are saying they go together.
They go actually
together.
Because
we are saying power and authority is required.
Yes.
Both have to come together. Yeah. Okay, this is how Jesus put it. Jesus said, the words that I speak unto you, they are
spirit
and life. And they are life. Okay. You have people who have gone for the word.
Mm-hmm.
And now he gives us the other scripture. The letter killeth.
Mm-hmm. The spirit gives life.
Oh, but the spirit gives life.
Mm-hmm.
So who is the ideal child of God? We're not talking about minister yet.
Mm-mm.
Because all of us are children of God.
We're children God first.
Who is the ideal child of God? Is the one who is moving in power and might, power and authority,
mm-hmm.
spirit and life.
Yes.
The word and the spirit.
Yes.
Together. In conjunction.
Yes.
And then he says, this sign shall follow
mm-hmm.
them that believe.
Yes. Yes.
So God has made it in such a way that you cannot wake up and say, but I said that, or I said what is in the word. He would say, but did you believe it?
Right.
Because the component of did you believe it is the component that brings in God in the picture.
Yeah.
That's the component that invites God to his word.
Yes. And that's a component that brings a transformation.
And that's the component that checks you out.
Mm. Oh, yeah.
Because eloquence without inviting God in the picture makes you do whatever you want to do. That's called power.
It's called power.
Because if you practice power on this other side, you practice power on this other side too.
Mm-hmm.
In other words, if you're practicing power, this is my gift, this is my talent, this mm-hmm. is my skill, I'll lay hands on you, I'm going after the anointing, you will also practice power in how you treat people.
Yes. Oh, yes.
You will insult them when you feel like,
mm-hmm.
because you are the one on the high seat.
Yes.
You are the power one.
Mm-hmm.
And then you can wake up and do whatever you want to do. I mean, we are talking about the child of God who is also a church leader,
mm-hmm.
who is also a bishop.
Mm-hmm.
They can spend the money however they want
mm-hmm.
because they are the bishop.
Mm-hmm.
No, that's not true.
No.
It shouldn't be like that because we don't want stale power. We want the freshness that comes from Jesus being present in the equation.
Yes.
So child of God, listen.
Hallelujah.
You can name anything. You can claim anything. And believe me, in doing that, you can also come into a place of witchcraft. You can come into a place of manipulation and control.
Yes.
And not realize that your power got it for you. So what are we admonishing you tonight? We are saying, don't just go for power. Don't just go for the anointing and fast for the anointing.
Mm-hmm.
Pastor Pauline, I remember the days in which, even today, people preach about or teach about the double portion. Many people don't know how to preach the word or teach the word from understanding that the scriptures of the Old Testament are void of the unity of the Trinity
mm-hmm.
that is in the New Testament.
Mm-hmm. Christ in you, the hope of glory.
Right. And so in the New Testament, child of God, God looks at you and says, the operation of the Father, Son, Holy Ghost has to be with you.
Mm-hmm.
So the concept of a double portion isn't applicable in the New Testament because in the Old Testament, it talked about increments.
Mm-hmm.
In the New Testament, the Spirit is one.
Right. And even in the Old Testament, Pastor Peter, when he asked for a double portion, he asked for a double portion of Elijah's spirit. He didn't ask for a double portion of the Holy Spirit. There is no double portion of Holy Spirit. Holy that Spirit is Holy Spirit.
And that's why we are saying what
growing,
we are saying.
He's not increasing.
That's what we are saying, what we are saying. And Pastor Pauline, it is with that same vein that teachings have gone out that people need to pray for the priestly anointing. But wait a minute. We are kings and priests.
He's made us kings and priests.
Right? We are kings and priests. He has made us kings and made us priests. So there is no special tarrying before the Lord, praying and fasting for the priestly anointing. And then there are teachings that say you have to, that you have not arrived the maximum of power that flows in your life until you come into the kingly anointing. Listen, when you have the kingly anointing, when you have the kingly anointing, it could sound wonderful and make people scream and make people shout. But it is the same Holy Ghost.
It's the same Holy Ghost. And you, the like we said earlier, the level at which you operate in authority is dependent on the extent to which you submit.
Yes.
To the authority.
Yeah.
You know, so if you are too big to submit to authority, then you are too small to exert authority.
That's it.
You know, so the level of the operation of authority in your life over situations is directly proportionate to the extent to which you submit to that authority.
Right.
So as we spend time in the presence of God, that's the reason why we stay in the secret place, because you want to build your relationship with the Holy Spirit. You want to increase in that active, living, vibrant connection with the Holy Spirit, because He is the vine and you are the branch. And as long as there is that connection, then the oil flows.
Yes. So as the deer panted for the water, so my soul longeth after you. The more I have Him, The more I seek you.
Yeah.
So the more of God should provoke even more of God.
Yes. Yes.
So typically, when you come out of a service and the power of God moved, when you leave there, you should go back and say, oh God. Mm.
You go right back into that place.
Oh my God.
And worship Him for what He, you know, praise Him for what has been done, worship Him for who He is, and stay in that place and say, Father, you are my everything.
Yeah.
You are my source.
More of you.
More of you.
And
that means more yielding on my part.
Yes.
Father, help me to yield even more.
Because if you pray prayers like, oh God, may you do it like you did it in this service, then you have not understood.
Right.
It has to be, Lord, I saw how far you took me yesterday. There is more.
Yes, help me to yield more. Open my ears more so I can hear you. May I be more malleable in your hand so I'm sensitive to your instructions and I don't fight the instruction. May I die to my flesh so it's not about my opinion. It's not about the way I see it, but the way you see it. So I can be easily yielded to you and allow you to flow in and through me.
Come on.
Because the more we die to self, the more God is seen in and through us.
Yes. So Pastor Pauline, as we are having this conversation, right? As we are having this conversation, this is what we are saying. We don't just want to be people who lay hands on their Christians. Mm-mm. Or speak into their Christians' life. Or even now that we are having the Kange household of faith and bringing to people the word of restoration, we don't just want to do that. We want to go beyond that and stir up the law for more of God in everyone who's listening to us, to the point that they would also say, I can speak a thing and it comes to pass.
Amen. That's the agenda.
Where they come to the Kange household of faith, hear the word, and go right back and lay hands on the things that are in their homes.
Yes.
And then they come and give the testimony.
Yes.
And then we say, yes!
Walking in the overcoming power.
Oh my God. Pastor Pauline, one of the things I did not mention earlier on is this boy who had the broken bone, who had the miracle of another bone growing within and it pushed the older one until the place was closed up. Uh-huh. Was not prayed for by the man of God. It was just the oil that was prayed for by the man of God. The mother had to take the oil and spray it. And the mother said, walk, my son, in Jesus' name. That is what we are looking for. We want to see how God multiplies fruits.
Yes. So it's not a one-man show. God never intended church to be a one-man show.
Yes.
The Bible says in Ephesians chapter 4 that the fivefold has been given to prepare the church.
Yes.
Prepare the saints so they can come into a place of maturity, so that the saints can do the work of the ministry.
Right.
Not for the fivefold to do the work of the ministry while the saints are spectators watching you perform.
Right. That's not the plan.
That's not the plan. That's not the agenda.
Yeah.
So if we are effective in our assignment, then we should be able to raise an army.
Come on.
Raise soldiers who are stepping out and doing the same.
Yes.
Who are also restoring other lives.
That's right. That's the plan.
That's the plan.
That's the agenda. So, child of God, let me bring this verse in perspective. Luke chapter 9. Excuse me.
Luke chapter 9.
Luke chapter 9.
Okay.
All right. So we're going to read Luke chapter 9 and permit me read from verse 1. The Bible says, then Jesus called the 12 together and gave them power and authority.
And
authority. Mm-hmm. He gave them power and he gave them authority. Over what? Over all demons. Right? Over all devils, over all demons. Mm-hmm. Right? Mm-hmm. And power to cure diseases.
Yes.
And power to cure diseases. Very important. And power to cure diseases. Now, in the King James Version, it says, then he called his 12 disciples together and gave them power and authority over devils and to cure diseases. Mm-hmm. So the power was also, the power and authority was also over disease.
Yes.
Not just demons, but also over disease.
And to cure diseases, yes.
The Bible says, and he sent them out, verse 2, to proclaim the kingdom of God and to heal the sick. So that's the same thing that we are flowing in. We are flowing in power and we are flowing in authority.
Yes.
And with this, we overcome the world.
Amen.
With this, we overcome the world. With this, we overcome the world.
Amen.
With this, we overcome the world. With this, we overcome the world. So understanding power and understanding authority is very important.
Yes.
With this, we overcome the world. So he was saying, I am giving you authority. So don't do it without me.
Mm-hmm.
Stay connected.
Stay connected.
Stay connected. Stay connected.
As the living Father has sent me, live by the Father, so I send you, and so you will live by me.
Hallelujah.
Stay connected.
Stay connected. So we are committed to staying connected.
Yes. We are choosing transformation over attention.
Yeah.
We are choosing testimony over pity party.
That's right.
In the name of Jesus.
And Pastor Pauline, we might as well say we are choosing wholeness over cycles of sickness and pain.
Yes. Amen. Because when we stay connected, and you've been healed from sickness and disease, you can move from being sick and getting healed into a place of living in health.
Right.
That's a possibility in God.
So hallelujah. We
press in for the transformation.
Yes.
We press in for that place of commitment and fellowship. Mm. Constant fellowship.
Yeah.
Constant fellowship, not a break and reconnecting and breaking and reconnecting.
We are building momentum. There is no such thing as, I'm really tired. I want to take a break.
We don't take breaks.
Take a vacation with your earpods.
Yes.
Listening to the word of God.
That's right.
Don't take a vacation from God, because then you will be oppressed.
Of course.
And that is what happens with many people. They say after hitting such a high, they meet with depression.
Mm-hmm.
No, after meeting a high, you go back to the high.
Pastor Peter, I think you should speak to that. please. Okay. Look into the camera and speak into that, because that is one of the things that I heard a lot from ministers as I was growing up as a child of God. At the time, not being in the position of a minister like you would say I am today, I heard that a lot from a lot of ministers, where they will come out from a ministration where the power of God moved powerfully, and then you look at them after that, they look so depressed, and some of them were very mean. And you, it was challenging to establish a connection between the minister that you saw on the pulpit and the one that is off the pulpit.
Okay.
So how can you make sure that people don't find themselves in that state?
So let's establish two things.
Yes.
Number one, the person who ministers is a supernatural being. Mm-hmm. And at a time, the anointing of God is upon them for that ministration.
Okay.
So they are operating in the level of what we might describe as an animated being. Mm-hmm. They are operating in that place. Mm-hmm. Their flesh can only carry that kind of glory for so long.
Okay.
So when they come from that place, it is really as though they dropped.
From a high.
So that is a tangible reality.
Okay.
But is it the absolute truth? No.
Okay.
So what does the absolute truth say? When I go that high in the glory, and God has done all the things he has done, I leave that place and go back to this place. So let me explain. After Jesus performed the miracles and did all of that, he retreated to the mountain. Why do people retreat downwards? You should retreat upwards.
Oh, come on. Amen.
You should retreat upwards. When you retreat upwards, hallelujah, you don't fall.
Thank you, Jesus.
You don't fall. My God. So this is what happens. You deal with demonic spirits. You deal with the ancient serpent, right? You deal with these things, and so you have warred in the spirit, and you don't realize how much it took a toll on your flesh.
On your flesh, on your body.
So when you come down, then the tiredness begins to set in. The depression sets in. And now, what is depression? Depression is the constant barrage, if you would, from demonic spirits telling you that you did not have the right to ascend onto that place and challenge them. So they begin to talk to you about your shortcomings. Mm-hmm. And they begin to throw in appetites. Why do they do this? They do this so that you will use your own mouth and destroy what has happened.
Oh my goodness.
In the life,
are you guys getting this?
In the life of Elijah, he said, everyone.
Yes.
I am the only one. And God was counteracting those words by saying, oh, please, you're not the only one.
Yeah, I've kept from myself.
But he had gone so deep in that place that he wasn't receiving what God was saying.
Yeah.
To the point where he pushed and said, now I want to die.
Right.
And God did not contend with him and let him go. So
we
many
need to
people,
retreat upward.
Yeah, you have to retreat upwards. You have to retreat upwards. Yeah. That's right, Pastor Evelyn. Retreat upwards.
Yes.
Because especially for someone like you, you're going to move in this glory realm. And as you move in the glory realm, there are many things you're going to deal with. And just generally speaking, right? There are many things that we deal with when we come into that glory realm. We have to come down and eat. Mm-hmm. We have to come down and relate with people.
Yes.
And that's the reason why every minister of God, every child of God, has to practice the presence of God, fasting or not fasting. You have to practice the presence of God.
Yes. Come on, say that again.
You have to practice the presence of God, fasting or not fasting. This is very important because some people are only as spiritual as when they are fasting.
Right. And when they are not fasting, they are mean like rattlesnakes.
Yes, and that's a problem. So you have to practice the presence of God while you're fasting, and practice the presence of God when you're not fasting. Mm-hmm. There are some people who cannot go through a meeting without being on a fast. So sometimes you have to go seek the face of God, stay there, and then come down. Jesus went up, stayed 40 days, and then came down and power moved.
He came in the power.
So you can see that that even as the word of God shows on several occasions, there are times when people fasted. And then they say, oh no, these people are weak. Let them take some honey so they can regain their strength. Mm-hmm. So as a child of God, you also have to know when to come away.
Yes.
And say, okay, I have fasted so much.
Yeah.
I have gone this far.
And walk in the awareness of the ability to still stay in that atmosphere of glory,
though you are not on a fast. This is really crucial, Pastor Pauline.
Very important.
This is very important. Yeah. So, child of God, while you are in that place, retreat upwards.
Yes.
Retreat upwards. I gave an example. An example of retreating upwards would be after you have flowed in a meeting, miracles, signs, and wonders, the glory of God has moved, right? Come back into this place and don't say, whoo, hallelujah, and go right into eating and jumping and jesting and doing all of that. You kind of look weird.
Yeah.
But you have to come over here and say, Lord, thank you for what you have done.
Get in the secret place, get into that worship atmosphere, create that atmosphere again and bask in it.
Right, that is you now coming over on this other side.
Yes, yes.
That is very, very important because if you don't do it that way, the enemy will come and begin to contradict everything. Yeah.
And it also helps you to make sure that you give all of the glory to God.
That's right.
Everything that happened in that service, you hand it over to Him.
Yeah.
All the accolades, all the praise, all the miracles, all the testimonies.
Yes.
It's your opportunity to hand all of that over to Him in that atmosphere of worship.
Yeah.
And it keeps you in that high, if you may say. But at the same time, it balances you out.
Yeah, we have
so
the
you don't have a crash.
We have the habit of talking about what God has done.
Yes.
So what happened during the service? What was said that was striking?
Yes.
You know, we talk about those things, and they keep us praising God.
And the book of remembrance is
open. You know, praising God, praising God, praising God, and so it keeps
Thank
us
you,
in the
Jesus.
High.
Yes.
The next thing is this: understanding that the enemy doesn't have, shouldn't have, what it takes to quarantine you after you have ministered.
Go for it.
Because
I think we have a few minutes that you can have.
After you go like that in the spirit, after you go like that in the spirit, the enemy is saying, okay, you have ascended. So, child of God, understand this. When you go up, Angela Carter just came on. God bless you. Good to have you on. The moment your name came on, I began to hear the word, a word from the Lord concerning you. Please just let me know if you're still watching. Let me make sure that it's you were not just passing by.
Thank you.
I have a word concerning you. And so this is what the word of God is saying. The word of God shows us that on several occasions, when people go up, the enemy cannot follow them.
Ooh, snakes can
snakes don't deal with height. Yeah. So the higher you go, the more challenging it gets for the enemy to follow you.
Yes.
It's like someone said it. If you're struggling with cigarette smoking, just stay around people. If your conscience is the type that wouldn't smoke around people, then you'll find yourself gradually distancing yourself from cigarette smoking.
Right.
It's so funny. It's an interesting concept. But yeah, that's what we find. But now, when you start coming down, what do you meet? The same demonic spirits you left down here.
Yeah, when you were ascending.
So every time you hit a high in the spirit, don't go down. Don't go down. Stay there. Stay there. Stay there, stay there, stay there, acclaiming, stay there, speaking, stay there, declaring, stay there,
worshiping,
doing all of that. So the enemy will not say, oh, wow, you went up, we missed you. Now you have come, we quarantine you and do whatever we want to do with you. So, child of God, if you follow those steps, then you should be fine. You
Amen.
Should be fine.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Praise
Bless
God.
The Lord. So
Thank
I was
Lord.
Asking about Angela. And
I didn't see her response.
I didn't see a response, so we're going to let that go.
Thank you, Jesus.
We're going to let that go.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. But Angela Carter, it's a woman of God. What a very strong apostolic grace upon her life. And I wanted to release that word upon you. But in case you watch that, I mean, you can get back to us later on. Hallelujah. But God is speaking volumes to us.
Yeah.
About the things that he wants us to walk in.
Yes.
And by his grace, we will walk in the declaration of Jesus. Mm-hmm. Out of Luke chapter 9, verse 1 and verse 2.
Yes. He gave them power and authority.
Yes.
Over all devils.
Yes.
And to cure all diseases.
Yes. Yes.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hi, Dominic.
Thank you, Lord. We'll walk in power and authority.
So anyone who's ever been in a situation where they say, well, I don't know, I was powerful last 2 weeks, but I don't seem so powerful right now. Okay. You have gone and unplugged from the authority. You have unplugged from the authority. Yeah. So you don't have a sense of the backing. And sometimes many people take advantage of the power that they have seen. And they tell themselves, oh yeah, I'm doing well.
Yeah, I've achieved this height,
it's okay.
And they just let go even of the daily disciplines that built them up to that height.
Yeah.
And that's the reason why it's so important to have daily disciplines in your life as a child of God.
Ooh,
you know, those daily disciplines help as a support for you to not go below a certain point. Even if you are coming from a high, you can go down, like down, because you have those daily disciplines. So you move from that, like you say, retreat upwards.
Yeah.
So I like the way you said it, retreat upwards. I like that.
Hallelujah.
Retreat upwards.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Excuse me. We are going to read some of the testimonies that came on.
Oh, yeah.
And if you have a question also out of this teaching, you can type out your question. You can type out your question, and I believe we should be able to respond. Robert says, the Lord will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen. They will have to help us to pin some of the testimonies that had gone ahead.
Yeah, so
I know
so,
Patrick
so
had a testimony.
Hallelujah. But before we get into that, let's just pray. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Lord, you are good. Lord, you are good. Lord, you are good. Lord, you are good. Lama banda raba baba shanda laba kata labro sondo. Father, we thank you for your faithfulness in our lives, O God. We thank you for how far you have brought us. We thank you for what you're doing, Lord God. Be exalted, O God, in the name of Jesus. Father, we pray for anyone right now who has lost their authority, who doesn't have a sense of the power you have given unto them. We pray, Father, that there will be a refinement. There will be a return even now in the name of Jesus. We give you glory, Lord. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Welcome, Carol Langwe. Good to see you. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. On Thursday, Pastor Pauline, on Thursday, listen, guys, all of you who are listening to us, We want you to engage on Thursday in retreating upwards.
Yes, amen.
We will engage in retreating upwards on Thursday.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
All right, that's Patrick's testimony.
Yeah, retreating upwards. So on Thursday, let's come to the broadcast in a, you know, I haven't been in a place of fasting and prayer. Mm-hmm. And when I say fasting and prayer, I'm not talking about, you know, you just staying without food, right? Mm. I'm talking about you having a scripture, two scriptures, three scriptures, four scriptures, five scriptures that you're just meditating upon the whole day. Mm-hmm. You know, stay on that. And you can do that even when you're not, quote unquote, staying away from food, as
right.
in fasting.
Right.
And that's what we're talking about, being
yes.
able to practice
yes.
the presence of God that way. So Thursday is going to be exciting. You don't want to miss that session. We are going to be doing what the Lord would have us do. So we
Amen.
Are going to retreat upwards.
Yes, that's
Amen.
Right, Jeris. Retreating
yeah.
upwards.
We are retreating upwards
yes,
to
yes.
the glory of God. Amen, 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 amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Okay, so testimony number one, Patrick Chambers. He says, July 4th, I was in a car accident. I broke my pelvic bone and had surgery the next day. Let's see this. Mm-hmm. Had surgery the next day. I was discharged from the hospital on the 15th to a rehab facility. From this point, I have been watching the Kange Household of Faith every Thursday and Tuesday, and sometimes Sunday. It has been tough and at times very painful, but I have managed to get through. I am getting discharged on Thursday. Yay! Woo! Hallelujah. He says, I lost because, let me see, I kind of missed that.
Of the accident, my probation officer sent me an email yesterday offering me a job.
Oh, that's so good.
Because of the accident.
He had lost his job, and so the probation officer sent an email for a job. So that's beautiful. Really been challenging. I'm finding myself. Okay, I'm changing.
Yeah.
I've been changing. I'm finding myself. I guess you're moving into a place of patience, more accepting of things. Okay,
amen.
All right, we'll see that. Praise the Lord. This is really good, Patrick.
Hallelujah.
God bless you. God bless you. We are glad.
Praise God.
We are glad what God is doing in your life, and
yes,
we are looking forward
yes,
to more.
Yes.
I believe that you're one of those who's going to be traveling the nations for the gospel.
Amen.
So get yourself ready, for God is going to do great things. Amen. In your life, in Jesus' name.
Amen.
All right. Someone also sent a testimony.
Evelyn.
This is from an anonymous source.
Oh,
that's okay.
Okay.
After the Kange Household of Faith, I had a short experience with God. I saw a woman who was naked, and something told me this is the demon that has been bothering me. Okay. Then God asked me to bless those who are opposing me. So I did. And let me see. Then the word blessed came to my mouth, and it said severally,
you are blessed.
Okay, Carol, you are blessed. Okay, praise the Lord. So that's wonderful.
Then
it's,
I slept.
It's good.
I have
and
never
you slept.
Experienced this before.
Oh, hallelujah.
What
God
is the
bless
meaning
you.
Of this?
God bless you. That's really exciting.
Answer the question, what is the meaning of this?
Oh, she said, what is the meaning of this? Well, there's no other meaning but that God came into your life and did something wonderful.
You're free.
Yeah, you're free.
And he told you exactly how to walk in your freedom.
Yeah. So
release
the people, brand new
forgive
place.
Them and move forward.
Yeah, in a brand new place.
Amen.
God bless you. Hello, Mokube Jr. God bless you. Thank you for joining us.
Welcome.
Welcome.
All right, there's a testimony from Evangelist Evelyn. Last week, I declared that I received money in my account, and actually, I received it 2 days ago.
Oh, wow.
And favor, I bless God for Family Corner because it has encouraged me greatly. More grace.
Amen. Amen. God bless you.
Praise God.
That's good.
Hallelujah.
That's
hallelujah.
Good. We like these testimonies because, you know, they get we get to know what God is doing, what God is saying, right, Pastor Pauline? We get to know that. That's wonderful. Oh, hallelujah. Let's see.
Sister Malu, good to have you. God
okay.
bless you.
Amen. So we are having this from Pastor Evelyn. Let's see.
Thank you, Jesus.
Are you able to see Pastor Evelyn's? I'm clicking on it, but
she just said retreating upwards. Thursday, August 6th.
Yeah.
Retreating upwards, looking forward.
Okay. All right. So it's gonna be wonderful. We are looking forward to
Tatiana
what...
says she's typing her testimony.
Okay.
Sorrel.
That's good.
Hi, Sorrel Gale. Good to have you.
While we are at it, Sorrel and Robert. I am not sure. I know I've not spoken with you guys for a little bit, but I'm not sure what you guys went through. But I could see that you guys went through something, and this is like maybe 2 weeks ago or more. And whatever that thing was, it caused a shift for you guys. Almost as if you dropped. Someone just falls off from a place of stamina. Mm-hmm. So I'm not sure what happened to you guys more than 2 weeks ago. More than 2 weeks ago, you guys came into something that shook your stance in the Lord. And it's almost as if you lost your faith, your flavor. And you lost your flavor, you lost your flow in the glory. But even now, if you would raise your hands up right now, there will be a replenishing. God will bring you back into that place and will begin to weave into place whatever you lost in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. Okay. All right. All right. Okay. Hallelujah. Ladies and gentlemen.
So remember, guys, as she's typing her testimony, remember, we are going for transformation.
Yes.
We choose transformation over attention. So we are going for transformation.
Yeah.
We are going for power and authority.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. We are not settling for just power. We are going for power and authority. God wants us to have both. He's giving us both. Yes. We choose to make advances and not make excuses.
That's right.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
We choose to have testimonies rather than settle for pity party. We refuse. Mm-hmm. In the name of Jesus.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. We settle for a walk of faith.
Amen.
And not for a need for attention. We refuse. How did you call it? Romantic soup?
Yeah.
We choose a faith walk over romantic soup. Yeah. In the name of Jesus.
You know, Pastor Pauline, there are children who want attention from their parents.
Mm-hmm.
Spouses who want attention.
Yeah.
From
each other.
From each other. Mm-hmm. And this is really detrimental to faith if it is not done right.
Yes.
No form of attention expressed through pity party, you know, will bring about an enhancement of faith. And listen, guys, stop practicing it.
Yeah.
Don't practice it, because the day you will need to overcome, you will not be able to. Right. It will be just your nature to express this other thing, and you don't need that.
You just say what you mean and mean what you say. You know, we don't like it when our children manifest negative attention.
Mm-mm. And first of all, that's manipulating.
It is manipulating.
So you are siding with the devil.
It is witchcraft.
To take a toll on you.
It is witchcraft.
so
don't
do
it. Refuse it.
Hallelujah. Refuse it. So guys, remember, on Thursday we are retreating upwards.
Yeah.
Amen. We are going into that place. Woo-hoo! With the Lord, and it's going to be wonderful.
Yes, it's going to be wonderful.
It's going to be exciting.
Amen.
We are looking forward to it.
So we are going for transformation.
We are going for transformation.
We are going for transformation in the name of Jesus. Like blind Bartimaeus, we are casting off the garment.
Yes.
As we're heading towards him for more.
That's right.
We are expecting. Scripture says, as the when the cloud is full of rain, it will empty itself upon the earth.
Mm-hmm.
So we are building as we go along, you know, leaning in more and more into Jesus, you know, practicing the presence and advancing further and further into him, so we can come into greater levels of authority.
Oh, wow.
In the name of Jesus.
Praise the Lord. So Sorrel says, I was not able to sleep for weeks, but after the communion night, I was able to sleep so good. I thank God for the night.
Amen.
Okay, praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Sister Diana from Kenya has a testimony. Just want to testify that God has been faithful in my life the last 3 months. Mm-hmm. My rent has been paid in full without me putting in a cent, and have catered for my father's medical bills and also bought his medication. Praise God.
Hallelujah.
Woo-hoo! Hallelujah.
That's wonderful. While we are at it, there
Thank
is someone
you,
right now. I see a wound on your leg. I see a wound on your leg. And God is healing that wound. God is healing that wound. I see a wound on someone's leg.
Okay.
And God is healing that wound. And it looks like this wound is connected to diabetes.
Okay.
So there's a diabetic situation there, and God is healing that
Thank
condition
you,
right now.
Thank you, Lord.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord. Thank
Hallelujah.
You, Lord.
Glory, glory, Hallelujah. Glory, glory. Glory.
Hallelujah.
Yes. God has been so faithful, doing a lot of wonderful things.
Yes, he has.
And we have come to the close of the session today.
Yes. Oh, Amen. Hi, Caroline Okanga. Welcome. Welcome.
Yes.
Welcome, Pastor Dada. Welcome. Welcome. Welcome.
Pastor Dada, we're mentioning the testimonies that you had given earlier on. So,
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. To God be the glory. So, guys, we have come to the close of our session today. It
yes.
was beautiful. It was wonderful.
Yes, 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 yes.
And we are looking forward to Thursday. Thursday is going to be wonderful. So come, stay in a place That's right, Patrick Chambers.
Amen.
2021 year of missions. Amen.
Amen.
And I say amen with you.
That's a good
Hallelujah.
Memorial stone.
That's right. That's right. That's right.
Amen.
So,
amen,
so we
amen.
Thank God for everything that has happened today. We give God the glory. Mm-hmm. We give God the honor. On Thursday, we are believing God for some miracles.
Okay.
On Thursday, we are believing that you're going to be a conduit.
Like
so this is what I want you to do on Thursday. Make sure that in your home on Thursday or wherever you'll be watching from, that there is someone who is going to receive a miracle because you will become the conduit. You will either lay hands on them or you will put oil on them or you will just speak a word as the word is coming forth. So on Thursday, we are going to have a massive crusade. Woo!
Amen.
I'm liking this. On Thursday, we are going to have a massive crusade. So fill your house. Oh, whoa.
Okay.
Something is being stirred up within me.
All right.
Fill your house. Labra gazokori aramako shendere bebe. E kataleya bogozandara baba. Fill your home with people who need some miracles from God. Do a party. Do a Kange household of faith party at your house and you know, put it on a big screen. Let them watch. And we are believing God for a move of God.
Amen.
We are believing God for a move
awesome.
Of God. Rabashanda Rababa. On Thursday. So Thursday, we are retreating and we
are retreating upwards.
Are retreating upwards. And we are making that a miracle day.
Amen.
A miracle Amen. Day. Miracles for those who maybe have not heard from us before, right? We want to connect with people so that they can get the benefits of what we have been getting here on the Kange household of faith.
Amen.
And it's going to be wonderful.
Amen.
It's going
Amen.
To be wonderful.
All right, Pastor Peter, Sister Diana says, actually, that is my father. He has a wound on his leg and he is diabetic.
Okay. All right.
So
healing is coming to that wound.
Yes, in the name
healing is coming
Jesus.
To that wound. And we are really going to stay in a place of prayer for him for Thursday. We are not postponing this miracle. We are not postponing it. But Thursday shall be an amazing day. Thursday shall be a day of recovery.
Amen.
Right? Thursday shall be a day of impossible conditions becoming possible.
Amen.
We are believing Amen. God for bones to grow.
Amen.
Just like it happened with that boy.
Yes.
Just Amen. Like it happened with that boy. So on Thursday, get ready with your anointing
the
oil.
God of
get,
all flesh.
Get, just get ready with that. We Amen. Are going to be in the presence of God. And we are going to see what God is going to be saying to us on Thursday. It's
Amen.
Going to be wonderful.
Pastor Peter, remember one of the things you talked about the last time we were in the broadcast was about God healing animate and inanimate things?
Yes.
Yes, a testimony from Pastor Peter. Our refrigerator was leaking
Come on.
Onto the floor for some weeks. I changed the filter, but it didn't change anything. A week later, based on Pastor Peter's instruction, I anointed it with oil.
Mm-hmm.
Now the ice maker is working again and no more leaking. I don't have to call the repairman anymore. Woo! Come on, Jesus!
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
The healer is in the house.
That's
he
right.
heals animate and inanimate
So guys,
things.
I hope you're hearing that, right?
Hallelujah.
I hope you're hearing that. There are people whose tires, right? There are tires that have had constant leaks. Got repaired.
That's right.
By the power of God. So there is no telling what can happen. Listen, on Thursday, we are expecting God to do some dental work.
God has handyman angels.
Yeah, God will do some dental work on Thursday. So let's get ready and come fired up. Fired up, because
amen.
We will see the glory of God
amen.
At another level.
That's
so
right.
Child of God, get ready on Thursday. It will be wonderful.
Amen.
And there is something else we want you to get ready for.
Thank you, Lord.
We want you to get ready for something on Thursday.
Okay.
Now, every time we have come to the broadcast, we'll do offerings as usual.
Mm-hmm.
But we would like to dedicate, not this Thursday, but the upcoming Tuesday for a Thanksgiving Day.
Okay. So next week, Tuesday.
Next week, Tuesday, we are dedicating that as a Thanksgiving Day. And prepare yourself for that Thanksgiving Day. Prepare a different kind of offering on Tuesday to bring to the Lord. Amen. To bring to the Lord. We want to make it a Thanksgiving Day. The things God has done. They are, I mean, where do we start speaking?
Phenomenal.
Where do we start speaking? So Tuesday coming up is going to be Thanksgiving Tuesday. We want to take the time and thank God. We've not done this since the broadcast started, but we just think we should take that day and just thank the Lord. But remember, Thursday is going to be what it's going to be. And God is going to be glorified in Jesus' name.
Amen.
We are going to be having Minister Nettie come up and Minister Joanne. They're going to lead us in offerings.
Okay.
But the Lord God is faithful.
Yes. Oh, hi, Pastor Kema. God bless you, sir.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
God is good. God is good. God is good. God is good. So that's it for our broadcast today. God bless you richly. It was so great having you guys around. So make sure you save the date for those things. Save the date. What will be happening on Thursday? We are retreating upwards. Remember that. I began to see in the spirit how a serpent had taken its skin out, right? Mm-hmm. But we are going to come against that thing, because those things that are firing up to come against you this time around, they shall be dealt with.
In the name of Jesus.
In the name of Jesus. So thank you, Lord God.
I like that, Thanksgiving Tuesday.
Yeah. So we are going to have Thanksgiving Tuesday.
Amen.
And it's coming up really quickly in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So Pastor Pauline.
Yes, sir.
So let's go ahead and release blessings upon the people. Go ahead.
Father, we thank you for your servants. We thank you for your sons and daughters. We thank you for tonight. We thank you for your hand over every life. We thank you that your blood is speaking better things on our behalf in the name of Jesus. We thank you because you've disappointed the devices of the crafty, so their hands cannot perform their enterprises. We thank you, Lord God Almighty, for your protection over every life, over every home represented on this broadcast tonight. We thank you for the healings that you have performed. We thank you for the deliverances that have been accomplished tonight. Even the things that we are still to walk into the awareness of. We give you praise in advance because we know you are the God of all flesh and there's nothing too hard for you to do. We thank you for the healing of the refrigerator. We thank you for the healing of the diabetic. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you. We thank you for your provision for the Sister Diana. We give you the praise, oh God, for provision for Brother Patrick. We thank you for every testimony, even the ones that were not spoken on the broadcast tonight. We thank you for the provision of a job for Paul. We give you the praise. We decree and declare that as your people leave this broadcast tonight, we are not leaving your presence. We begin retreating upwards even from tonight in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you that you enable us to establish routines in our lives, oh God, disciplines that will keep us moving forward and upwards in the name of Jesus. We have declared tonight that we settle for transformation in the name of Jesus. We settle for power and authority in the name of Jesus. We choose transformation over attention. We choose to make advances and not make excuses in the name of Jesus. We choose testimony over pity partying in the name of Jesus. Father, we thank you for your hand over every life. We decree and declare that we are overcomers. We go forward and backwards never in the name of Jesus. We go forth with testimonies and we are conduits of the glory of God in Jesus' mighty name. Amen, 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 amen. Hallelujah. Woo-hoo! That was an exciting time in the presence of God. I hope you are going to take these nuggets that were shared tonight. God spoke on some very intense things. And for those of you who came in a little late, we implore you, we encourage you to go back and watch the replay, watch everything from the beginning, because there were some deep truths that were addressed tonight, even about welcome, Minister Nettie. Even when Pastor Peter was giving us nuggets on how to stay in the high after a major ministration, those were some deep nuggets that will literally take our lives to new heights in Him. And as we continue to walk in the reality of what God's word says, we choose transformation over attention, right?
Oh yes, definitely.
If we want romantic soup, we just ask for romantic soup.
We don't need to attach it to some pain, attention, and suffering.
No, we don't need to connect it to anything negative. We can have romantic soup if we want to.
Yes, ma'am.
It's our right in Christ Jesus.
Yes, ma'am.
Right?
Yes, ma'am.
Exactly. Hallelujah. For those of you who don't know what we're talking about, that's why you have to go and watch the whole broadcast from the beginning, so you can know what we're talking about when we're referring to romantic soup. But we appreciate every one of you joining us tonight. God bless you, and we look forward to seeing you on Thursday. All right, Minister Nettie.
All right. Thank you so much, Mommy. We were blessed. I pray that you guys were blessed.